Look what kind of people Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُتَحَابِّينَ فِيهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves those who love each other for my sake. وَالْمُتَجَالِسِينَ فِيهِ. And those who sit in a gathering, like this gathering, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَالْمُتَبَابِلِينَ فِيهِ. And those ones who exchange gifts for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَالْمُتَزَاوِرِينَ فِيهِ. And those who visit each other for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imagine. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لَا تَدْخُلُ الْجَنَّةِ حَتَّى تُؤْمِنُوا. No one shall enter paradise unless you believe in the oneness of Allah. وَلَا تُؤْمِنُوا حَتَّى تُحَابُوا. And you shall not believe unless you love each other. وَهَذَا دِينُ النَّاقِصِ. Your iman is not completed till we love each other for the sake of Allah. If you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala 24-7, make siyam, make zakah, make salah, but you don't love each other, your iman is not complete. Imagine. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, أَلَا أُدُلُّكُمْ عَلَى شَيْءٍ إِنْ فَعَلْتُمُوهُ تَحَابَبْتُمْ. Shall I tell you about a way? If you do it, you should love each other. قَالُوا نَعَمْ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. قَالَ أَفْشُ السَّلَامَ بَيْنَكُمْ. Spread peace among yourselves. Shake the hand of your brother Muslim. Whenever you shake his hand, with strength. And whenever you hug him, squeeze him. Show him that you really truly love him. And imagine when somebody shakes you the tips of your fingers and he's looking the other direction. No, shake his hand. Say, well, brother, I love you. For the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The people who love each other for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, listen to these beautiful words. They will be ala manabira min noor. They'll be sitting on seats made out of not wood. ليست من خشب ولا فضة ولا من ذهب ولكن من نور. These seats will be made out of noor. On day of judgment, people sweating, their sweat reaching their knees, reaching their waist, reaching their shoulder. But these special people, special status, they be sitting on seats made out of noor. وَوُجُوهُهُ مِن نُورٍ. And their faces glowing out of noor. The anbiya, the prophets, and the shuhada, they will be saying, who is these people? What kind of creation is this? فَيُنَادِي مُنَادٍ وَيَقُولُ هَؤُلَاءَ الْمُتَحَابُّونَ بِجَلَالِي. Those ones who love each other for my sake. Imagine, we love each other, you'll be sitting on seats made out of noor. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be among those type of people. Also, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Mu'adh ibn Jabal radiyallahu anhu, he was sitting with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by themselves, them two by themselves. The Prophet telling Mu'adh, Ya Mu'adh, Wallahi inni uhibbuka fillah. Oh Mu'adh, I swear I love you. Imagine Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam holding your hand and telling you, Oh Mu'adh, I love you. قال والله وأنا أحبك يا رسول الله. And also I truly love you, O Prophet of Allah. But Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم did not leave him there. He wanted to give him an advice. He said, Oh Mu'adh, do not let, I want to give you this advice. Do not let for each salah, whenever you're praying, before you finish your prayers, before you make tasleem, say this beautiful dua. اللهم عني على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك. Oh Allah, give me strength by remembering you. and worshiping you and thanking you. Before you make taslim, say this beautiful du'a. Oh Allah, give me the strength in thanking you and remembering you and worshiping you. One time Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, sitting with his companions, a Bedouin man came in. وقال يا رسول الله متى الساعة متى الساعة يا رسول الله, interrupting Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam majlis by asking this question. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not answer him right away. قال يا رسول الله متى الساعة, then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam answered this question by a question. وماذا أعددت لنا, why are you asking me when is the hour, when is the day of judgment? What have you prepared for it? Why are you asking me about what has met a sa'a? قال والله يا رسول الله ما أعددت لها كثيرا من صلاة ولا صيام ولكن إني أحب الله وأحب الرسول. Oh Rasulullah, I swear that I haven't prepared much of good deeds like salah and siyam, but I love Allah and I love His Messenger. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied back by saying, Al-mar'u yuhsharu ma'man ahab. You will be with who you love on the Day of Judgment. Then Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu was sitting when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said this. He said, Wallahi, inni uhibbu Allah, wa uhibbu al-Rasul, wa uhibbu Aba Bakr, wa uhibbu Umar, وأحب علي وأحب عثمان وأسأل الله عز وجل أن أكون معهم يوم القيامة. And I ask you and I ask myself, who you love? Do we truly love Allah and love His Messenger? Or just words we are saying? لا بد من العمل. عائشة رضي الله عنها, she said, جاء رجل إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وقال يا رسول الله والله لأنك أحب إلي من ولدي وأهلي ومالي ونفسي. Oh Rasulullah, Allah is my witness that I truly love you more than myself, more than my children, more than my wealth. But oh Rasulullah, whenever I go home, I don't have the patience. I cannot wait till I come and see you the next morning. And I remember, on the Day of Judgment, you enter paradise, you'll be with the prophets, the highest place in paradise, and we'll be a different level. How can I see you and how I can be with you? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَالرَّسُولِ, whomever follow the orders of Allah and His Messenger, who you will be on the Day of Judgment? مَعْ مَنْ؟ مَعَ النَّبِيِّينَ وَالصِّدِّيقِينَ وَالشُّهَدَاءِ وَالصَّالِحِينَ. You'll be with the prophets and the Siddiqeen and the Shuhada and the righteous ones. But لَابُدَّ مِنَ الْعَمَلِ, you have to do act upon it. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to command the Sahaba. They love him, but they acted upon it. After one of the battles, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to look at his companions. Who's he missing during the battle? Who got killed? So he commanded Zayd ibn Harith radiallahu anhu. He told him, go ahead. Go ahead, look for Sa'd ibn Rabi'. I don't see him among us. Go see where is he at. So Zayd, he kept looking, looking in the wounded people till he found Sa'd ibn Rabi'a radiallahu anhu. He found him the last breath. The ulama said he had 60 wounds in his body. And he's already leaving this dunya. He was sakarat al-maut. Qala ya Sa'd, inna Rasulullah ya'tika as-salam. وَكُولُ كَيْفَ يَجِدْكَ, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم giving you the salam, and he's worried about you. How is your status? قال يا زيد وإلى رسول الله السلام وعليك السلام يا زيد. Tell Rasul عليه السلام, give him the salam. And peace upon you, O Zayd. والله إني أشم رائحة الجنة من مكاني هذا. Tell رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, I'm leaving this dunya, but I can smell paradise from my place right here. They truly love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to make wudu, the companions run and grab the drops of water coming down. If a hair drops down, they grab it. If he gives an order, they rush and do it and obey him. If he talks, they listen. Whenever they send people from Mecca to spy on the Muslims and how they treat the Prophet, they come back and they said, Wallahi, we never see any kind of people. They love their messenger like the Sahaba, they love their messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Do we really truly love Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Or just lip servicing? Just like we come to the masjid. Like Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam commanded us to come to the masjid. Even the people cannot see. In the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he used to also command them to come to the masjid. هَلْ تَسْمَعَ الْأَذَانِ هَلْ تَسْمَعَ الْإِقَامَةِ فَأَجِبْ لَا أَجِدَ لَكَ رُخْصَةً. Even another person showed me, brother showed me on YouTube the other day, a man is blind and he ties a rope from his house to the masjid. And this blind man, what he does, he grabs the rope and he comes all the way to the masjid and attend the 5 salawat. See, and now these days, people so healthy, they have no problem at all. Subhanallah, they don't attend the masjid. من غدا إلى المسجد أو راح أعد الله له نزلا كلما غدا أو راح. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever comes to the masjid early, and we're talking early, Salat al-Fajr. And ghada, ghada comes later time to the masjid. Salat al-Dhuhr, Asr, Maghrib, Isha. What is the reward, ya Rasulullah? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepare for you nuzul. Al-nuzul ma yu'addu ila al-dhaif min karama wa dhiyafa. When a guest coming to you, important guest, you prepare for him the food, where he's going to sit. You're coming to the masjid, the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imagine what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala preparing for you on the Day of Judgment. So loving each other for the sake of Allah is a high status. And the second segment of today's talk, to forgive each other. وَسَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ وَجَنَّةٍ عَرْضُهَا السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. وَسَارِعُوا, let's haste, let's run. For what? Jannah. And the description of this Jannah, heaven, paradise, عَرْضُهَا السَّمَاوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضِ, the width of it, like earth and the heavens. أُعِدَّتْ لِمَنْ, who is this Jannah for? أُعِدَّتْ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ, it was prepared for those righteous ones. مَنْ هُمْ يَا اللَّهِ. أُعِدَّتْ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالدَّرَّاءِ, those who spend in the time of ease and time of difficulty. وَالْكَاظِمِينَ الْغَيْظِ, those who hold their anger for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ, and those who forgive each other for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wallahu yuhibbu al-muhsineen, and Allah loves those righteous ones. One time Amir al-Mu'mineen, Harun al-Rashid, a woman giving water while he's making wudu, and she dropped this water made out of, you know, glass, dropped it. And Amir al-Mu'mineen, his face became so red. She told him, oh Amir al-Mu'mineen, wal kadhimin al-ghayb, and those who hold their anger, qala kadamtu ghaybi, قالت يا أمير المؤمنين والعافين عن الناس، قال عفوت عنك. قالت الله يحب المحسنين، قال اذهبي فأنت حرة لوجه الله. He told you are free to go for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-kadhimin al-ghayb, those who hold their anger, لا يغضب. A young man came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and told him, give me an advice. Advise me, O Rasulullah. He told him, لا تغضب. Do not be angry. He said, give me another advice. قال لا تغضب. He told him, do not be angry. He told him, give me another advice. قال لا تغضب ولك الجنة. He said, do not be angry and you shall receive paradise. And it's not easy to hold your anger for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وليعفو وليصفحوا ألا يحبون أن يغفر الله لهم. Forgive each other. And after you forgive, you forget. وليعفو وليصفحوا. Sometimes I forgive you, but I still have an anger in my side. No. But yasfah, forget. For the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And to be united, help each other. خير الناس هم أنفعهم للناس. The best of the people, who are they? Those benefit each other. If you need help, I should help you. If you need help, I should help you. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us in this beautiful hadith, Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu, he used to make i'tikaf in the masjid. A man came to him and told him, Ibn Abbas, I need your help. I have some debt. I owe some man some money. I need you to go talk to him. So Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu, holding this man's hand and leaving the masjid. A man stopped him and said, Ibn Abbas, ayna tadhhab? Where are you going? You're in a state of i'tikaf. He told him, yes, I know. But my brother here is in need. وَأَنَّنِي سَمِعْتُ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ يَقُولُ مَنْ مَشَى فِي حَاجَةِ أَخِيهِ كَانَ خَيْرًا مِنْ اِعْتِكَافِ شَهْرًا كَامِلًا فِي مَسْجِدِي هَذَا. He said, yes, I know, but I have heard Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم saying, whoever go for the sake of his brother need, better than making a whole month i'tikaf, where? Not in any kind of masjid, in the Masjid al-Nabawi, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Imagine how many of us love to go to the Hajj, to go pray in the masjid. But just helping your brother, better than making one whole month i'tikaf to Masjid al-Nasulullah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And to love each other, and forgive each other. In the time of Umar radiallahu anhu, two men grabbing this young man, bringing him forth, and they said, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, this man killed our father. So Amir al-Mu'mineen telling this young man, did you really truly kill their father? He said, yes, Amir al-Mu'mineen, but it was accidentally. I didn't mean it. So he told Amir al-Mu'mineen, told this two men, forgive this brother. They said, we need justice. This man killed our father, we need justice. This man telling Amir al-Mu'mineen, can you give me 3 days so I can go back to my family and inform them what's happening to me? I have a mother and a father and children. I need somebody to take care of them. Let me go back and inform them what's happening to me and I come back. He told him, who will guarantee you till you come back? So this man looking in the majlis of Amir al-Mu'mineen, he said, who will guarantee me for 3 days? So I go back and inform my family and come back. No one is rising up. Except this old man raised his hand, Aba Dharr radiallahu anhu. Qala ana ya Amir al-Mu'mineen. I will guarantee him 3 days till he get back. This man leaves, 1 day go by, 2nd day go by, 3rd day by Salat al-Maghrib. They bring in Aba Dharr. He said, this man doesn't show up, didn't show up. So we're going to take you. So this man coming running forward. He said, ha ana ya Amir al-Mu'mineen. Here I am. So Amir al-Mu'mineen and the people said, we don't even know where this man, where he lives, what village is he from. So Amir al-Mu'mineen asked him, what made you come back? He said, oh Amir al-Mu'mineen, I don't want to come on the day of judgment saying a Muslim gave a word and did not fulfill it. A Muslim, whenever he give a word, he fulfill it. And the man, when he asking Abu Dharr, how you guarantee someone you don't even know him? He said, "Oh, Amir al-Mu'mineen, my brother Muslim was in need. I don't want to come on the day of judgment and I'll be asked, your brother Muslim was in need, I did not help him." And these two men who pressed charges against this man, they said, وَنَحْنُ يَا أَمِيرُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ we shall forgive him. We don't want to come on the day of judgment on Muslim asking to beg us to forgive him. We did not help him. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be among those who love each other for the sake of Allah. And love each other and forgive each other for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.